Hello, good afternoon, students. Jai Sanskar. So today we are going to complete the last video of this lesson, respiration in organism. And the last point, along with this last point, we are going to discuss 10.5, breathing in other animals as well as breathing under water, and do plant also respire. So basically, this is the last video of this lesson. Let's read and understand. Animals such as elephant, lion, cows, goat, frog, lizard, snake, birds have a lungs in their chest cavity like a human being. See, animals like elephant, lion, cows, goat, frog, lizard, snake, birds also have a same chest cavity like humans have. How do other organism breathe? Do they also have a lungs like those human beings? Let us find out. But what about the other animals? Is the other animals that also have a chest cavity like us? And if they do not have a chest cavity like us, how do they breathe? So in this point, we are going to discuss about the particular two animals breathing in other animals like cockroach and earthworm. So we are going to discuss about these two particular animals, that how do they breathe. The first one is insect animals, as an insect, and second one is earthworm. A cockroach has small openings on the sides of its body. Other insects also have a similar openings. These openings are called spiracles. See, you have also already known that some animals doesn't have a nose, and they doesn't have a chest cavity. So from where do they breathe? They breathing from the holes that is inside their bodies. In a body's in the jina chidro hoy che, through which they inhale. Jyanthi they inhale, exhalation, એટલે કે respiration kare che. The cockroach have a spiracle shaped, yani ki circle shaped openings. That's why they are called spiracles. Insects have a network of air tubes called trachea. See, they are also having a trachea. The pictures of tracheas are given like this. You can see in the picture tracheas for a gas exchange karva mate tubes jeva tracheas hoy che. Oxygen rich air rushes through the spiracles into the tracheal tubes, diffuse into the body tissues and reaches every cell of the body. Similarly, the carbon dioxide from the cell goes into the tracheal tubes and moves out through the spiracle. This air tubes or trachea are found only in the insects and not in other groups of animals. See, insects are also the group of animal, one kind of group of animal. So they respire like this, that whatever the air is around them get inside through the spiracle and passes through the tracheal tube. Similarly, passes through the tracheal tube and get diffused into the different cells ma padi jai che, and then carbon dioxide coming out from the another tracheal tube through that spiracles. This kind of ability is seen particular into the insect type of animals, not others. Now let's talk about earthworm. Recall from chapter 9 of class 6 that earthworm breathe through their skin. We also know that earthworm doesn't have nose. Apni jem nose nahi hai, so they breathe through the skin, the hole present in the skin. The skin of an earthworm feels moist, slimy on the touches. એની સ્કીન છે એકદમ સ્લીમી અને મોઇસ્ટ હોય છે, ભીની ભીની હોય છે. વેન યુ ટચ ઇટ યુ કેન ફીલ ઇટ. ગેસ કેન ઇઝીલી પાસીસ થ્રુ ધેમ, જેમાંથી ગેસ ઇઝીલી પાસ થઈ શકે. થ્રુ ફ્રોગ્સ ધો ધ ફ્રોગ્સ હેવ અ પેર ઓફ લંગ્સ લાઇક અ હ્યુમન બિંગ્સ, તે કેન ઓલ્સો બ્રીથ થ્રુ ધ સ્કીન વિચ ઇઝ મોઇસ્ટ એન્ડ સ્લીપરી. સી, ઇવન ધ ફ્રોગ હેવ સેમ ચેસ્ટ કેવિટી એન્ડ રેસ્પિરેટરી સિસ્ટમ લાઇક વી હેવ, વી હ્યુમન હેવ, બટ સ્ટીલ they also have a lungs, but still they breathe through the skin. Why? Because it is very easy for them to breathe through the skin. They are moist and slippery. Now the next point, 10.6, breathing under water. Breathing underwater. You also know that breathing underwater is possible only by the animals that are living underwater. Je underwater live kare che, each underwater breathing kari shake. Can we breathe and survive in water? No, of course. There are many organisms which live in water. How do they breathe underwater? See, but still there are so many animals that breathe underwater, and even some animals are like that water animals like that, like a fish. If you take them out of the ground, that water, and taken to the ground, they will die. તો ઘણા તો એનિમલ્સ એવા છે કે જેને તો પાણીમાં જ બ્રીથિંગ કરી શકે, બહાર કાઢો એટલે જીવતા નથી, જીવી શકતા નથી. યુ હેવ સ્ટડીડ ઇન અ ક્લાસ 6 દેટ ગિલ્સ ઇન અ ફિશ હેલ્પ ધેમ ટુ યુઝ ઓક્સિજન ડિઝોલ્વ ઇન અ વોટર. ગિલ્સ આર પ્રોજેક્શન્સ ઇન ઓફ ધ સ્કિન, ઓલરેડી એની સાથે જ પ્રોજેક્ટેડ હોય છે ગિલ્સ. ગિલ્સ આર શોન હિયર ઇન ધ પિક્ચર, યુ કેન સી ધ ઇન ધ ફિશ ધ ગિલ્સ ઇઝ લાઈક ધીસ, છિદ્રો હોય છે. That is present in the fish, which help them to do respiration. Gills are projection in the skin. You may wonder how gills help in a breathing. Gills are well slipped with the blood vessels. Gills no direct relation blood vessels સાથે હોય છે કે જેથી ફટાફટ સ્લિપ થાય અને ઓક્સિજન બ્લડમાં ભરી જાય છે. And for exchange of the gases, and even they can exchange the gases. Now the last point, 10.7, do plant also respire? Yes, plant also respire. Like other living organism, plant also respire for the survival, as you have learnt in a class 6. You have already learned this everything in a class 6. This is a revision of the same points. They also take in oxygen from the air and give out carbon dioxide, but this process is going on at night. During the daytime, they breathe carbon dioxide that is released by us, and they release oxygen. But at night, they are respiring. They are performing the perfect respiration for themselves only. So during the night time, they respire and they just inhale oxygen and gives out carbon dioxide. That's why you are allowed to not to go nearby any tree at night. In cells, oxygen is used to break down glucose into the carbon dioxide and water, as in the other organism. જેવી રીતે અધર ઓર્ગેનિઝમમાં ઓક્સિજન છે એ ભળે છે તો ગ્લુકોઝ બ્રેકડાઉન થાય છે અને કાર્બન ડાયોક્સાઇડ અને વોટર પ્રોડ્યુસ થાય છે. સિમિલરલી પ્લાન્ટ ઓલ્સો ડુ ધી સેમ પ્રોસેસ. In plant, each part can dependently take oxygen from the air and gives out carbon dioxide. Different parts independently take their oxygen. Not like us that we take in oxygen from our nose and then it reaches to the lungs and lungs provide oxygen to every other parts of the body. No. In a tree, like branches, roots, stems, everyone, they take in oxygen by themselves independently. In oxygen from, you have already learned this in chapter 1, that leaves of the plant have tiny pores called stomata and for exchange of oxygen and carbon dioxide. We have already learned this in chapter 1, that the leaves have tiny pores, that is called stomata, and stomata as you can call the kitchen of the plant, leaves are called the kitchen of the plant as well as the nose of the plant. Why? Because from that chidra, that holes, gases are exchanges. Like all other living cells of the plant, the root cells also need oxygen to generate energy. Roots like up air from the air space is present between the soil particles. See, like other organism, root also need oxygen to perform some activity. Oxygen, that is energy. See, the chart is given here, the picture is given here, that the air space is there in the soil. Jamin ni andar aj hava ni jagya hoy che, space hoy che. And this is the root hair and this is the soil particles. So where there is a root hair and the present space in that, any andar je soil ni andar root hoy che ane soil ni aajubaju j thodi space hoy che, empty space hoy che jya hava hoy che. So from that empty space air, they take in oxygen. Can you guess what would happen if the potted plant is over watered? જો તમે પાણીને પ્લાન્ટને વધારે પાણી આપી દો તો શું થાય? ઓફકોર્સ ઇટ સ્ટાર્ટેડ બીકમ સ્પોઇલિંગ, એ સડવા માંડે છે. ઇન ધ ચેપ્ટર યુ લર્ન ધ રેસ્પિરેશન ઇન અ વાઇટલ બાયોલોજિકલ પ્રોસેસ, જીવવા માટેની જરૂરિયાતમંદ પ્રોસેસ છે. All living organisms need to respire to get the energy needed for their survival. So for the survival, energy is needed, and the energy that is that is needed by the human being is only we get through by performing an process that is called respiration. So this lesson, the respiration in organism is very much important. Here the 10.5 as well as the full chapter is over.